These are the 2002 to 04 Orion 7 CNGs, the first Orion 7s, and the second CNG-powered low-floor buses for New York City Transit. Now, the fleet numbers that these buses range from are 7560 to 7819, with 7560 to 7587 being 2002 models, 7588 to 7684, along with 7685 to 7777 being 2003 models, 7778 to 7819 being 2004 models. Now, 7560 was the very first Orion 7 CNG to be tested for passenger service on January 28, 2001, under Gun Hill Depot. Then, shortly afterwards, the prototype itself went back to Orion Bus Industries as a new 7560 was delivered to New York City Transit. Shortly afterwards, 7560 to 7653 were delivered to Jackie Gleason Depot, and 7654 to 7819 were delivered to West Farms Depot. Since 2015, many of these Orion 7s have been swapped back and forth between Jackie Gleason and West Farms Depot, and in the spring of 2017, more than 20 units ended up going to Spring Creek Depot at MTA Bus due to a shortage that they were suffering from. And the bus fans, transit fans, were like,
oh my God, okay, it's happening. Everybody stay calm.
What's the procedure, everyone? What's the procedure?
Stay calm!
Wait.
I mean, we all know that someday they would be sent to MTA Bus, but no one was expecting Spring Creek to get them. I mean, if they went to College Point Depot, I would completely lose my mind. But anyways, moving on to the specs of these buses. So these Orion 7 CNGs were delivered with brand new features that were not shown on previous deliveries. However, 7560 to 7684 were the last ones to be delivered with the Illuminator Max 3000 flip dot destination signs, while 7685 to 7819 were delivered with Illuminator Hanover destination signs. These Orion 7 CNGs were built under the model number 07.501 CNG, with the 7 indicating the model of the bus, 501 indicating that the bus is 40 feet, and CNG indicating that the bus runs on compressed natural gas. Now, moving on to the powertrain. So 7560 to 7684 are Generation 1 models, and those signify the use of the Detroit Diesel Series 50G engine with the Allison B400R transmission. Together, they sound like this. $76.85 to $78.19 are Generation 2 units, and those signify the use of the Series 50G engine with the ZF Ecomat-2 HP-592C transmission. Together, they sound like this. Now 7691 to 7746 are pretty distinctive units because they were repowered with the Cummins Westport ISLG engine with the Allison B400R WTEC transmissions. Just like their younger sisters, the Orion 7 Next Gen CNGs from Long Island Bus. And together, they sound like this. They were repowered again with the Doosan GL11K engine and remained with the Allison B400R WTEC transmissions. Together, they now sound like this. What do I think about these buses? Well, they're okay. They're a good fleet, but nowhere as good as the Orion 7 hybrids, with the exception of a few nitpicks from both drivers, passengers, and transit fans. But hey, what do you expect? Now, before we move on with this review, here are some thoughts and opinions about these Orion 7 CNGs from my good friend Cedric, aka Vulnerable Toyota. Take it away, Cedric.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to my contribution of the Orion 7 old-gen CNGs. These buses are known to be personally my worst favorites in the bus history, because they came into New York City with boisterous growls out of their exhaust. After I moved into East Flatbush in 2009, I was catching up to riding these Orion 7s and hearing their growls started to get really interesting. But as I was growing up a little, they seemed to be more disturbing into the residents 24/7, and for me, they're personally getting more scary. This what makes my likable solutions happening in the MAP Stowa fleet, whereas two units in the Bronx at 7691 and 7746 were started to get repowered with two different engines. First with the Cummins ISLG engine, then they got repowered the second time with the Doosan GL11K engine. And in fact, the Doosan GL11K engine is really a best efficiency engine for a CNG bus. And to compare to these buses in our MTA agency, I also prefer those Orion 7 old-gen CNGs and WMATA in Washington, D.C. Those are the 2005 to 06 old-gen CNGs that were powered with the Cummins WPC gas with the Voith D.864 as a clean powertrain that I am interested, and I also wish that those MTA old-gen CNGs get as efficiency and more quieter. But on the other hand, there are other fun significance of these growls to prove how strong they can to be relayed to their speed, and also loud enough for near walking residents to be notified if the bus is coming or if they missed it. Even in motion, it seems to be their way of honking as a way to help out sound other cars in its way to move urgently. In regards to noise, up to my claim that the units at West Farms are known to be 3 times louder and aggressive compared to the buses in Brooklyn due to maintenance efforts. And speaking of the Bronx, there was a neighborhood of Country Club that protested the BX8 route where the Orion 7 old gen CNGs used to run on to be rerouted out of their neighborhood for more of a quiet community. So overall, I am only concerned about the bus's design, but the rest of the info is a drenched thought. So anyways, thanks for watching my contribution, though I could still honor these buses respectively on being the best Orion 7s, even though I prefer the hybrids more. So taking you back to the owner of this review.
Thank you, Cedric. Now let's hear some thoughts and opinions about these buses by my other good friend, Clayson, aka New York Bus Guy. Take it away, Clayson.
This is my contribution for Sonic 57053 for the Orion 7 old gen CNG review. So I grew up seeing these since 2006, back when they still had the black back and no black trimming yet. I have such fond memories of these. I rode these on the B8 and they sounded very, very good. I loved the gurgling growl sound, and man, hearing that was a real good treat. I loved how loud they were. I thought they were so awesome to see and hear on the B8 and B35, the routes I saw these buses the most common on. Of course, you had those units from West Farms as well, other than from Jackie Gleason, where those units had the LED displays, which was also a nice thing to see. Unfortunately, I only got to see the Orion 7 CNGs in Brooklyn and never in the Bronx, not even once. I would see these buses often in Brooklyn, so yeah, over the years that went by. Then by 2017, Spring Creek Depot received some of these, and they were nice to see on the B100 and B103. So yeah, that's just how things are. You know, they were great to see. But of course, with everything in life, things come to an end, so these had to retire by 2019, of course, due to the CNG tank expiration. With newer buses coming in, the XN40s taking their place and various other buses replacing them. But they were good to see while they lasted. So with that, I'll take it back to Sonic.
Thank you guys for contributing. Now, moving on to the review. So during their time with New York City Transit, these Orion 7s were later given the white back and decal scheme, while 7692 was given a funky design. In other words, not only it was given the decal scheme, but the doors were painted in black, which looks very bizarre to me. Although I have not rode on these Orion 7 CNGs, but I mainly rode on the Orion 7 hybrids, but don't get me wrong, I also like these buses, but I'm sure the Orion 7 CNGs served New York City Transit very well. With the arrival of the 2017 to 2019 New Flyer XT40s, they were given the fleet numbers 7484 to 7850. And the units that originally had the fleet numbers were retired before the Excelsiors came in. However, one unit in particular, 7685, was renumbered as 145 to prevent any confusion. By 2017, these Orion 7 CNGs started to retire slowly, and by May 4th of 2019, they were all gone. Although it's disappointing that none of these buses got a chance to be preserved for the museum fleet, but that's just how things work. Now before I end here, I want to dedicate this review as a birthday gift to the one and only Kalel C. Johnson. As of December 31st, 2020 is his 24th birthday, so make sure you guys wish him a happy birthday as I leave you his channel link in the description below. So, as for these 2002 to 04 Orion 7 CNGs, these buses are gone, but most certainly will not be forgotten, and will always be remembered as New York City Transit's first fleet of Orion 7s. So with that being said, this is Sonic 57053, wishing you guys to stay safe, stay healthy, and wishing you guys a happy new year, and thanking you guys for watching. And happy birthday, Kalel C. Johnson.